What you will notice coming up, you'll see some of the things are on the van. Now the reason we call it a bend down market, because you have the things you purchase, you have to bend down to pick them up. So we call it a bend down market. But right inside you can see part of the bend down market. That you can experience rafting on. The rafting village itself is 7 miles upstream. We have 120 rivers here in Jamaica and 4 mineral springs.
A landmark in Jamaica. This is where Christopher Columbus first landed in Jamaica in the year 1500. Now it is a historic tourist place. And we see a few other people photographing there. These are some of the tourist attractions. Craft shops. As we would like to remind you, we are on our way to the dance hall in Ocho Rios from the Holiday Inn in Montego Bay. This is where the people are buying tickets. See, to climb the 6,000 foot mountain, you need to have water socks because the water is very acidic as well as pain. The gentlemen take it easy before the climb. Signs, the tourist signs that show the landmark location. As you see, you might be able to read Columbus Craft. As we look around, we see the beach across there. In fact, the bay. And here are the tour buses. And as you watch, what you see by the bus is in fact a machine used for harvesting sugar cane.
Combined water cooler, calcified and filter first used in Jamaica by the Spanish settlers 4 centuries ago. Same area. This area is known as the Columbus Park. surface developed by the Kaiser Bauxite Company. It is maintained as a scenic attraction and repository for items of historic interest.
We are at Ocho Rios, a touristic center, and we have come to this location to look for some kind of typical Jamaican artifacts. And I've lost Aruni, of course, as usual, so we'll have to find him. I shall go shop by shop, try and locate her. Somewhere here. Do I see her? Yes, I can see her handbag. Yes. Yes, that's Aruni. I think so, yeah. Well, I can just about see her doing some kind of negotiation. Let's see what she has got in store for us. Let's get a little nearer. There goes our room to another shop.
That's okay. I got a better deal out there.
$15.
They paid half of that.
These are some of the hand carvings typical in Jamaica, and it's quite prevalent in Ocho Rios. It's quite nice indeed. They tend to quote you twice the price, so this one will typically be about $30 start off, so nothing you generally settle down for $12-$15 US of course. And once again you need to know how you buy and convert money. That was excessive for him. We'll try again. But he's up there. He didn't fall. He just let it go. And he's going to grab it back again. He's pulling with all his might there. He said, no, it's not coming up. Hey, Marco, you're doing good.
Who is a good batsman now?
Yeah. Greenwich.
Well, he's always been good. Yeah. 10 years ago.
A second discussion.
He didn't strike?
With the natives.
Perform like a Phillies confidence of
do they play?
So, do you...
But they have like, what they call it again?
Sheffield Shield, no.
Red
Stripe.
So we have those guys from Trinidad.
Yeah. But do you have also a Jamaican team from Jamaica only?
Uh-huh,
okay. So who is going for the test for your team, for Jamaica? From Jamaica?
Well, I don't know right now. We have about two guys right now.
Holding is yours, right? Holding.
Yeah.
Michael Holding, yeah.
Dujan.
Okay.
Well, he resigned.
But these are old players still, you know. They're 10 years old, 5, yeah, 10 years old now. You know.
They are good still.
Uh-huh.
They play for the island now. They're not playing for West Indies.
Is Clive Lloyd back here now or is he in England?
Clive Lloyd is not from here.
No, but is he in England still?
Yeah,
he resides there, right? I think he settled down.
He's not playing first class cricket anymore.
Is that right?
He's originally from Guyana.
Do you get television cricket here?
Yes.
Huh? Man, I like the game.
Oh,
I didn't know that. This is a good part of soccer, it is short. Man,
yeah, right.
1 hour and it's all over. This game of cricket you're going to watch a long time. Yeah, I know.
Yeah.
Entrance to the shuttle for express travel.
Waiting to climb the Duns River Falls. As you can see, everybody's got funny looking shoes. These are special shoes.
You want your ass to be so drunk and sit here at the same time? I can see me laying under the shower, hugging the pool toilet.
There's Michael with his shoes as well, the duck shoes. These are supposed to give special grips and also keep the stains away from your normal shoes. The whole team is going on. Of course, we are the covers. We're not going to make it. Only Marco's got courage. Roshan is pepping him up. Thank you. Bye. Waiting for guidance now. The final terms and conditions will be now issued, and there's everybody listening intently.
This is on our way to the river. It's called Ocho Rios.
This is where the Duns River meets the sea, and the climbers are preparing to climb the 6,000 foot Cascade Falls. And we can see Marco down there as well, holding just about, fading away. There's a tremendous amount of anxiety because all these are pretty steep and dangerous, as you will see later on. We will pick up Marco further on the other side now. What do you do now? Go to the other side and wait. There's Marco coming on into view again. A pretty treacherous climb. Everybody's holding on. They all have to walk in a row. Michael is a helping hand. On to the next ridge.
the master that the speaker speaks to. There's a little shopping complex in the compound. Continuation of the same compound.
Okay, we're going home now, so you can just sit back, relax, and listen to some reggae. We'll be right back.